Okay, we can start our session now. Wherever we guys have stopped from that particular point onwards, we are going to start your session. So once again, I welcome back you all to my second session of environmental awareness. And in this particular session, we are talking about social issues in environment. In last session, we guys have talked about watershed management. And now we are going to talk about another aspect or another issue which is there in the environment. Before that, please allow me to share my screen so that I can show you some slides, and through that we can understand better. So please allow me to share my screen, and here is my screen. Is my screen visible?
Yes.
Is my screen visible? Hello?
Yes, sir. Visible.
Okay. So here we guys have stopped, and up to this we guys have seen. We guys have seen the last point that we guys have seen, that was watershed management. And now we are going to talk about displacement due to mining. Mining means, as we know, that mining, there are different types of mines like coal mines, oil mines, stone mines. So because of mining activities, displacement is taking place, or displacement is there. So what sort of mines we have, that we are going to see. And whenever this kind of mines are there, these mines have, you know, displaced so many things. Just give me 1 second. Okay. So because of mining activities, certain displacements, or, you know, people are shifted. And because of that, there is a question, or there is a problem with, you know, what we call it, resettlement and rehabilitation. So mining industry is also responsible for displacement and resettlement and rehabilitation, because wherever mines are there, because of the safety issues and safety measures, government asks those people to shift themselves in certain area where they will be out of danger. So this is what this kind of things are taking place, this kind of you know, what we call it, just a minute, I'll stop. Hello. Can you hear me, boys and girls? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
So we will talk about displacement due to mining, and mining is the most important activity. And as we know that mines are there, coal mines are there, even stone mines are there, oil mines are there. Because of this kind of mines, certain, you know, displacement is taking place. So what we are going to see here in this particular thing, that is displacement of people because of the mining. So here certain points I have noted down that we are going to see one by one. Several thousand hectares of land are covered in mining operations. If we see, most of the land is operated under mining activities. If you visit Goa, if you visit Jharkhand, if you visit, you know, UP and NP, those areas, they have more minings, and they have more mines like coal mines and, you know, what we call it, oil mines, we don't have stone mines and all. So those areas, hectares, certain areas, which is called as in terms of hectares, that is covered under mining operations. Mining accidents also cause displacements. So when it comes to mining operations, there are certain chances of accidents which can be taken place. Those are also there. So because of all those things, the government will ask, or government asks people to shift themselves in certain areas where this kind of activities won't be there and people won't get affected. But at the time of, you know, shifting people, government will not take care of themselves properly. And then again, the question or the point arises about what? Point arises about their resettlement and rehabilitation. So here is one coal mine which is there, that is Haria coal mines, which is in Jharkhand, and 0.3 million people asked to leave the place because of this Haria mile coal mines, which is in Jharkhand, and because of this particular coal mine, people are asked to shift themselves from that particular place to another place. So, and the number is not small at all. 0.3 million people were asked to leave the place, or those are shifted. So now there was a question, or there is a question of their resettlement and what do we call it, displacement. Reason behind that was underground fires. Sometimes fires can be also taken place under the ground or in the coal mine. So in that case, it is very difficult to control the activities. So this is what people are asked to shift themselves in a safer zone. No alternative provided yet. Government has not provided any sort of alternative to them. Just a minute. Yes, sir. Nile, except for when? No alternative is provided by the government so far, and the government has not made any sort of provision for their, settlement and rehabilitation. Cost of R&R 18,000 crore. So the cost of resettlement and rehabilitation. R&R means what? Rehabilitation and resettlement. The cost of their resettlement and rehabilitation is 18,000 crores. Remember. So that is also important one. That is also most important part. But government has not taken steps to, get it done. And whenever no government will take those steps to get it done, that will be more appropriate as such. So this is for displacement of due to mining. Then displacement due to creation of protected area. So see, government has also created some area that's protected area and the prohibited area. So people are not allowed to get in, or people are not allowed to visit that particular area, and that particular area can be called as protected area. So because of this kind of protected area also, certain displacement or certain rehabilitation and resettlement issues are arised, or certain resettlement and rehabilitation problems are arised or emerged or created. So what are they and which are they, that we are going to see. Displacement also takes place where protected areas are established as compensatory measures for the forest lands and natural habits that are lost. What happened, because of this kind of protected areas, displacement is taken place in those kind of protected area, and the government has not taken compensatory measures as such. Government has established as compensatory measures for the forest land and natural habitats that are lost. But the government, at the same time, government should have to make necessary provisions for such kind of people, those who come under the category of protected areas. But there is no provision, and again, when there is no provision, again, they may face some problems regarding their resettlement and rehabilitation. A welcome step for natural resource conservation. Actually, this protected area is a very good idea, by the way, but at the same time, there should be a provision for rehabilitation and resettlement. Through such kind of protected areas, actually, this one is a step for conservating or conservation of resources that we have, especially natural resources. So through such kind of steps or such kind of creating areas or called as protected areas, government is trying to conserve natural resources basically. Then, but tribal lose their right to their natural homes. But basically, whenever it comes to protected areas and all, basically in forest, mostly tribals, they reside. So they are losing their rights, they are losing their homes, and they are losing their natural homes, and which is not good as such. So as far as tribals are concerned, they are losing their homes and they are losing their natural rights. Entry is prohibited in core areas. So whatever protected core areas are there, in those core areas of land or protected areas, entry is totally prohibited, that we need to understand. And then Valmiki Tiger Reserve, that is 142 villages in Bihar of Tharu community. So as far as this Valmiki Tiger Reserve sector is concerned, this one is a protected area where 142 villages in Bihar of Tharu community are of affected. Then Vayananda Wildlife Sanctuary, that is 53,472 tribal families in Kerala. So Vayananda Wildlife Sanctuary is also a part of protected area, and through this particular protected area, 53,472 tribal families are affected. So this is the displacement due to creation of prohibited area. So whatever government wants, they can create, because it is for the society only. But at the same time, government should take care of their resettlement and rehabilitation, which is going to, or who are going to affect because of this kind of protected area, mining area, watershed, and so on. So that sort of precaution government has to take before going for any sort of developmental or development projects or development plans or for anything else. Then rehabilitation issues and policies. So there are certain issues and there are certain policies which are related directly or indirectly regarding rehabilitation issue, rehabilitation of anything, whether it is rehabilitation of a dam or dam affected people or mining affected people or, you know, anything else, or displacement of anything else. In case of that, there is a question of, or the strong question is what? Rehabilitation. If proper provisions are made, if proper care is taken for the purpose of rehabilitation, then whatever issues we face, whatever policies we make for the purpose of rehabilitation, those are accepted. But if we do not make any sort of provisions for the purpose of rehabilitation, then there is issues, there are certain issues, there are certain policies that we need to reframe. So we are going to see what sort of rehabilitation issues and policies are there as far as rehabilitation provision is concerned. The first one, right to housing, a basic human right. So those who are what affected because of such kind of development projects, they have a right to have a house as human right. It is under the right of human rights that everyone should have his or her own house. If you have your house and your house is acquired by the government for the purpose of development project, then there is a duty of the government to provide a house to you. If government is unable to provide, then you can also take this point, or you can sue government to the court for getting your human right, that is having a house. When government acquires land for various reasons, as we know that government acquired lands for so many reasons. Government acquired land for government activities purpose, government acquired land for dam, government acquired land for canal, dam, you know, even for roads, for railway tracks, and so on. For any reason, there is a right for the government to acquire your land by paying proper amount of remuneration. So by paying a proper amount, they can acquire your land. But at the same time, not only money is enough in return of your land, they have to provide resettlement, they have to provide rehabilitation for you guys, and that is expected. Already poor tribals most affected, as we know that those who are tribals, and if they are poor again, then those are highly affected because they don't have any other option of their livelihood that can be taken place. So already poor tribals which are affected, most affected, those should be taken care. The loss of land, food, home, jobs, property, assets, social isolation. So see what happens when government acquires our land, government, you know, ask for resettlement and, rehabilitation. In that case, we lose our land, we lose our food, we lose our home, we lose our jobs, we lose our property, assets, and social isolation. So in that case, government has to take care of rehabilitation of those people, those who are affecting because of a certain project, because of a development project as such. Cash compensation not enough. As I told you, cash is not enough if government is going to pay the money. So government cannot say like that, we have paid the cash, now you manage your own. No, cash compensation is not enough. Whatever amount they're paying in cash, that is not enough. Even government has to provide another things also, as they have, you know, asked you to resettle, as they have asked you to rehabilitate. So this is what cash compensation which we are getting from the government, whether it is in lakhs or crores, it doesn't matter at all. That is not enough as such. Tribals are unaware, so might be a case of cheating. So most of the people, you know, those who are not educated, so they don't know their rights, how much cash should be received from the government, what can be done if they do not get enough cash compensation as such. So in that case, they may be cheated as such, or they may be a case of cheating for themselves. So this is what I told you earlier also before this particular point. Cash compensation, if we are getting from the government, that is not enough as such. If we do not provide any sort of rehabilitation and resettlement facilities to them, then there is a question as such. Communal settlement does not happen. So what I'm going to say here, in case of rehabilitation process, in case of rehabilitation and resettlement process, communal settlement is also the one of the important part, one of the important aspect that we need to take care of. And it is not happening, by the way. So all these are the issues which we have seen. Now we are again coming back to the certain issues which are that which we can observe as far as nature change, or which are affecting on the nature also. So whatever we have seen, those were social issues. Now we are going to see natural issues. What is happening because of changes in the environment? As we know that environment is changing day by day, and because of changing in environment, we guys are facing so many things, or so many changes in the environment also. And out of those changes, the first one is what? Climate change. As we know that day by day, the climate is changing, and we don't have seasons now. In any season, we are experiencing so many things in any season. We are experiencing rainy season till or during the entire year. So these things are happening. We can see rain in any season now. Now, I think last week only we had rain in Baramati, even in Pune or in across our country. So why it is happening? Actually, this one is the season of winter. We should have cold in this particular month, but cold is not that much like, previous 3-4 years. So this is what is happening. Climate is changing. And for what? And for this kind of climate change, or this kind of unusual climate change, who are responsible? We people are responsible, because we have made damages to the environment, and now environment is giving in return of that. I think I was about to give you one example. I think last week only, on 4th December, I was traveling to Pune in night at 9, almost 9 or 9:30, like that. So when I passed this Karavagas, that village, after that, I was unable to drive my car. Because of what? Because of fog. You cannot imagine fog, huge amount of fog. There was a huge fog. And because of that fog, I was not able to drive. Even I was not able to see what is there in front of me. And it was happening with everyone. And the cars or vehicles were very slow. So finally, I took my car aside and stopped for 30 minutes. Huge, huge fog was there. And 2-3 vehicles, left the road and they got down. So it was not expected. You cannot imagine fog at 9:30 in the night. Not expected. We can expect fog early in the morning at 4 o'clock, 4 a.m., 5 a.m., 6 a.m., like that. Up to 7 a.m., it is okay. But in night or in afternoon, we cannot expect the fog, but it is happening. And why it is happening? It is happening because of what? Climate change. Climate is going to change. And climate, this kind of changes of climate will affect on us also. It will affect on weather. It will affect on environment. And definitely, if it is going to affect our environment, it will be more dangerous. If you take an example of Delhi, in Delhi, till 1 o'clock or 12 o'clock, there is a fog. And whatever situation we guys have faced in last week, similar situation they face every day. So Delhi is the most polluted city in our country. People are suffering from pollution, and that Delhi is called the most polluted city. Why? Because industries are there. People are creating some vehicles. Huge vehicles are there. So many reasons are there, and because of that, Delhi is called as what? Most polluted city in our country. So similarly, it is happening with Mumbai. Similarly, it is happening with Pune also, and it will happen with Baramati one day if we do not take proper care. So climate change, why climate is changing? There are certain reasons. And the reason is what? Behind the climate change, we people, means man-made or human activities, are responsible. And when we stop doing all those activities, one day climate change won't be there. But we should take care of it from this moment. And that is expected, right? So see, we are talking about climate change now. climate change is average weather of arena. Climate change means what? Average weather of arena. And controlled temperature, evaporation rate, seasons, moisture content, etc. Climate means nothing but what? It is a temperature, evaporation, then moisture, etc. Conditions, if prevail for 30 years, it said to be the climate of an arena. Currently, climate is changing. If you look at the last 3-4 years or almost 10 years, if you take an example of last 10 years, see the how the change, climate is changing, how the changes are taking place. And if we go for that sort of changes as far as the climate is concerned, climate is drastically changing. And because of climate changing, we guys are suffering a lot. How we are suffering, that we can see. Now, because of the climate changes, we are observing global warming. We can see nowadays, we can see anything in any season. पहिले असायचे की उन्हाळ्यात फक्त खूप गरम व्हायचं, हिवाळ्यात थंडी व्हायची, पावसाळ्यात पाऊस यायचा. आता असं नाही. Nowadays, we cannot see such kind of things. We experience anything. In morning, we experience you know, a very humidity or very hot. In between or in evening, we feel, you know, something different. Or in evening, we have rain. And then down, it is meaning party, we feel something sort of cold. So in a span of one day, we experience all the seasons. And why it is happening? Because of climate change and global warming. So overall increase in temperature, few degrees. Day by day, the temperature of the world is increasing. Temperature of the world is increasing, and when it is going to increase more and more, it will be called as global warming. And it is happening. I will tell you one example. Don't, you know, if I forget it, you please remind me. It happens when greenhouse gases, who are they? Who are the responsible factors or the responsible things for the purpose of global warming? Because we guys have started playing with the environment. We guys have started something doing wrong with the environment, and because of something wrong with the environment, we guys are experiencing this kind of climate change and global warming. So it happens when greenhouse gases, greenhouse effects we have, greenhouse storages we have, and those storages, they create gases which are responsible for global warming. Then carbon dioxide, water vapor, nitrous oxide and methane trap heat and light from the sun in the earth's atmosphere, which increases the temperature. Okay, so all these things are responsible to increase the temperature, and all those things which we guys have created, remember, if we have a control around this, we don't have this problem of global warming. But we are running behind the money, we are running behind the development, we are running behind the, you know, physical materials and all those things. And this is what global warming is taking place. And global warming is, and whatever points we guys have seen, that is greenhouse gases, carbon dioxide, water vapor, nitrous oxide and methane. These are the stimulants for the global warming. This hurts many people, animals and plants. Global warming is going to hurt not only we people, it is also going to hurt animals and plants also. Even human beings, plants and animals are also suffering from global warming. Many cannot take the change, so they die. And of most of the people, those who are especially elders, even animals also and plants also, they are not comfortable with this kind of global warming change, and they die. They don't have any option. They die because they cannot survive in this kind of global warming situation. So this is the global warming. And what about the facts which we can see here? There are certain facts that we can manage, that we can see. As far as the global warming is concerned or climate change is concerned, there are certain facts which we guys have taken here. And the facts are unsustainable consumption pattern of the rich industrialized nations are responsible for the threat of climate change. So who are responsible for this? As we know that most of the cases, those countries which can be called as developed countries, they are responsible because they have a unsustainable consumption pattern. They do not think about tomorrow. They just think about today, and they go for more and massive or aggressive consumption of natural resources. They go for more and more industries, and these industries are also creating pollution. And because of this kind of pollution, it is going to happen. So what is happening here? This kind of pattern of industrialized nations or rich nations or developed nations, they go for excessive consumption of natural resources, and because of that pollution is taken place, and when pollution is taken place, it will affect on the climate change anyhow. Next one, only 25% of the global population lives in these countries, and if we consider the population which is residing in those countries, then out of 100%, only 25% population is residing in these rich industrialized nations. Remember, so in these industrialized nations, only 25% population is residing. Remaining 75% population is residing in, underdeveloped or developing countries. And because of the activities of these rich industrialized nations, we all are suffering. Because they are having rich industrialized, they are having unsustainable consumption pattern. And because of their pattern, we guys are suffering. So this should be somewhere pointed out, and then it will be beneficial for all of us to get it done. But they emit more than 70% of the total global CO2's emission and consume 75 to 80% of many of the other resources to the world. So this is the fact, and that already I have told you. Impacts are already being seen in unprecedented heat waves, cyclones, floods, salination of the coastline, and effects on agriculture, fisheries, and health. What happened? The effect is there on different things. Effect is there in the form of what? Unprecedented heat waves. Achanaka sasya garam vafayala suru hotat. Kanchalam kisarge vafayala suru hotat. Then cyclones. We guys have, I think, in last 2-3 years, we guys have experienced 2-3 cyclones. Every year we get cyclone. Vadala jala pramanto. So cyclones and storms we are experiencing every year. I think this one is a fact of last 2-3 years. Every year we are facing the cyclone, even in Maharashtra also. Forget about south side states, they face every year. But in Maharashtra also, we guys are facing certain cyclones. Then floods, every year we are facing this problem of floods, especially those who are from Western Maharashtra, they may understand, especially Sangli and Kolhapur. They are facing floods, every year they lose their household. And again, they stand up and do the same things. The salination of the coastline, and there is the effect of all those things on agriculture, fisheries, and health of the people. So these are the facts that we cannot deny. Now, here are certain climate change evidences. We have taken some evidences, and from those evidences, we can understand what sort of climate changes we have. If you look at the climate change, then here are certain evidences with us. Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. I think government is also thinking about such kind of climate change activities. And this is what Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change is established by the government. Then published evidences of climate change. Government has given some evidences which are showing climate change in our nation and in the entire world. Observe that Earth's climate has changed over years, and from those evidences, we can observe one thing. The Earth's climate has changed if you compare with previous years. Then average temperatures have fluctuated by 0.5 to 1 on Celsius. If you look at the fluctuation in the temperatures, and if you look at that average temperature fluctuation, that rate is, fluctuated from 0.5 to 1 on Celsius. So this is the information about climate change. Then anthropogenic activities are affecting climate. Anthropogenic activities are affecting climate. If anthropology is the topic, anthropology is the subject. So whatever activities are there which can be called as anthropogenic activities, those are getting affected. It's not uniform in all places. Poles will be more warmer. And this climate change is not same everywhere, and mostly the poles which are there, those are getting more warmer and warmer, which is not good at all. If you look at this, these are the situations which we guys are facing from so many days. We guys have faced the situation of you know, flood situation, especially in Maharashtra also, where you guys have seen so many, you know, this kind of situation. I think last 2-3 years we are observing this in Sangli and Kolhapur. How those people are living, we don't know, but this is the fact, and people are experiencing their such kind of dangerous activities, and they take care of themselves in this situation also. Greenhouse effect is the matter of discussion now. So as we know that greenhouse effect is one of the, you know, cause of global warming, and one of the causes of global warming. So here we can see how that greenhouse effect is affecting on the global warming. So we are going to understand what is greenhouse effect and how it is going to affect. What are the, you know, pollutants which are responsible for greenhouse effect? That also we are going to see. So see, the greenhouse effect is a naturally occurring process that aids in heating the Earth's surface and atmosphere. So greenhouse effect is naturally occurring process. It is going to happen. It is going to occur naturally. And because of that, it creates a huge amount of heat, and it will affect on the surface of the atmosphere. It results from the fact that certain atmospheric gases, such as, you know, when we get, what sort of gases we get from the greenhouse effects that they have given here. Gases such as carbon dioxide, water vapor, and methane are able to change the energy balance of the planet by observing long wave radiation emitted from the Earth's surface. So whatever gases we get from the greenhouse effect, those are affecting on the planet, and those gases are carbon dioxide, water vapor, and methane. And these are the you know, gases which are responsible for affecting the planet. And the long wave of radiation emitted from the Earth's surface. Without the greenhouse effect, life on this planet would probably not exist, as the average temperature of the Earth would be chilly 18%, 18 Celsius, rather than present 15 Celsius. From this particular statement, we can also understand the greenhouse effect and its impact on our day-to-day life. So anthropogenic activities increase the concentration of greenhouse gases. Enhanced greenhouse effects are also responsible for climate change and global warming. Carbon dioxide from emissions, whatever pollutions we get, if we are using vehicles for the purpose of traveling, then those vehicles are creating emissions, and through those emissions, carbon dioxide is generated, and carbon dioxide is, you know, a part of and the main, you know, pollutant of air pollution. Then chlorofluorocarbons is also the part of what air pollution. Methane and nitrogen oxide are also the part of what you know, global warming, and they are also giving their contribution in global warming situation. So this is the fact which we guys have seen as far as this one. So if you look at this image, you can understand the Earth's greenhouse effect, how it is going to happen, and from that you can also understand how it has been taken place. If you look at this picture, just look at this picture carefully so that you may understand the concept of greenhouse effect in a detailed manner. Getting? Now, the effects, we are going to understand the effects of greenhouse effect or climate change or global warming. Change in wind current patterns. The current wind pattern is changing because of this kind of climate change. Wind pattern is changing, and we can see the changes of wind also in our clear mind. The ocean currents will change. Ocean currents will also change. Then hydrological cycle will intensify. Then sea level rise, I think because of global warming, sea level is also rising. Submergence of areas. I think there is one movie. If possible, you watch one movie, which is in English, that is Day After Tomorrow. There is one movie, Day After Tomorrow, you watch it. They have shown how the global warming is affecting on the entire world. And they have shown, because of the global warming, how the sea level is increased or raised. Getting my point? So if possible, you watch this movie. This movie is available on YouTube. And if you watch that, you will be able to understand how the global warming is and what it is exactly. Changed agricultural production. Because of this kind of global warming and climate change, agricultural production has also changed. And some foods, some crops are also not possible to cultivate in our lands because of such kind of changes in the agriculture, changes in the climate, or changes in the nature. Then cases of flood, droughts, cyclones on a rise. If you observe last 15 days, it has been observed that most of the time we had flood, most of the time we had droughts, nidushkal, we had cyclones and all. As I told you, if you take an example of last 5 years, 17 to 21 or 16 to 21, in these 5 years, we guys have experienced everything. We guys have experienced flood, we guys have experienced droughts, we guys have experienced cyclones also. So everything we guys have experienced in this last 5 years, and it is happening again and again because of what? Climate change and global warming, remember. So this is for effects. Now the next point is global warming is affecting many parts of the world. It is not with India only, it is with everyone. Global warming makes the sea rise, and when the sea rises, the water covers many lowland icelands. This is a big problem for many of the plants, animals, and people on the icelands. As I told you, because of the global warming, sea level is rising, and when sea level rises, then there may be a question for the living things in the Iceland or the sea, like animals and plants, and people are also suffering, those who are residing on the icelands. So this one is the effect. The water covers the plants and causes some of them to die. When they die, the animals lose a source of food along with their habitat. So this is the things. If we go for that, the water covers the plant, and when water covers the plant, then they will definitely die. And when they die, animals may also lose their foods, and even we also lose our foods if it is happening. Then when the plants and animals die, people lose two sources of food, plant food and animal food. If we reside in that particular area, and if animal dies, definitely people, they may lose two different sources of food. The food that we get from the plants and the food that we get from the animals. They may also lose their homes, because if the sea level is rises, then definitely we may lose our homes also. As a result, they would also have to leave the area of or die. There may be only one question, there will be one option in front of them, either to leave the place or area or die. That could be the option. This would be called a break in the food chain or a chain reaction. One thing happening that leads to another, and so on. So it happens, getting my point. It happens because of global warming. So these are the effects of global warming, which we guys have seen. Then so many points are there that we need to cover. But these points we can cover in tomorrow's session. Just remember, we guys have stopped here. And we guys have to start from these particular slides from tomorrow's lecture. Till then, so I'm going to take a break here. I'm going to stop my presentation, and I'll get back to my home screen where you guys have to ask your questions. So I request you all to ask your questions if you have. If you do not have any question, then I can wind up.